Setting up Google Calendar delegation. As a personal assistant, you've probably been tasked with scheduling and managing events for your supervisor. To accomplish this in Google Calendar, your manager must make you a delegate and grant you direct access to the calendars they want you to manage. After being granted access, you can schedule new events for them and accept or reject invites on their behalf. In this short video, we'll use Mary and Paul to help demonstrate the steps needed to become a delegate of your supervisor's Google Calendar. Mary is Paul's supervisor, and Paul will become the delegate of Mary's calendar. In order for the personal assistant to access the supervisor's calendar, the supervisor must grant the assistant the appropriate privileges. In the supervisor's calendar, click Settings, and then Calendars. In the My Calendar section, click Shared Edit Settings for the calendar they'd like you to manage. In the Share with Specific People section, enter the email address of the individual defined to manage the calendar in the Person field, and if needed, click Add Person. In our case, this individual is Paul, Mary's personal assistant. The email address displays below. From the Permission Settings drop-down menu, select Make Changes and Manage Sharing, and save your changes. As the personal assistant, when you return to your calendar, you will see your manager's email address in the My Calendar section. Any events your manager currently has scheduled are overlaid on your calendar. You can change the color of either calendar by selecting an alternate color using the drop-down button to the right of their email address. And you can quickly hide or view either calendar by quickly clicking the associated email address. As a delegate of your manager's calendar, you'll probably want to be notified about events as they appear on their calendar. This can easily be done by clicking Settings. In the My Calendars section, click the Notifications link for their calendar. Select one or more of the options depending on when you'd like to be notified by email. You can also select Daily Agenda to have Google email you your manager's calendar on a daily basis. You can also define default event reminders for your manager's meetings. To define an event reminder, click Add a Reminder and define how you'd like to receive the reminder and how far in advance you'd like to be notified. Note that you can add multiple reminders. It's important to note that the notifications and reminders you set up as a delegate are for the notifications and reminders you wish to receive. If your manager decides not to receive email notifications or would like to set up their own reminders, they can define them by accessing the notifications area on their primary calendar. When finished, save your changes. When creating an event for your manager using the click and drag method, the event displays on your calendar by default since you are still within your primary calendar. To quickly switch the event to your manager's calendar, select their email address from the calendar drop-down menu. Notice that the color has changed to indicate the event is now associated with your manager's calendar. Enter the meeting topic and click Edit Event Details, and enter the necessary information and invite your guests. Notice that the default reminders you defined for yourself display in the Options section. When finished, save the modifications and send invitations to your guests. The event now displays on your manager's calendar, but not on your calendar. Frank was invited to the meeting and receives an invitation in his inbox. Opening the invitation, he can see that it was sent by Paul as the creator for Mary as the organizer. On his calendar, Frank also sees that the meeting was created by Paul, Mary's personal assistant, for Mary. Frank can accept, tentatively accept, or decline the meeting. Since Frank accepted the meeting, and Paul defined a notification to receive an email when individuals reply to their manager's meetings, Paul receives an email indicating Frank's decision to attend the meeting. And because Paul also chose to receive a reminder of the meeting, he also sees a pop-up reminder before the meeting.